see them, they're not worried about the waves. You shouldn't be worried about what's going to happen and all that. God got you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. God bless y'all. We're coming live from St. Albans, Jamaica, Queens. Amen. The Burns Memorial Church. BMCC, Burns Memorial Church of God in Christ. And we are gathering within the confines of the law. The law says no gathering no more than 10 people. And we have exactly 10 people, myself included. So we are following the laws of the land, but we are having church. Amen. And right now, I guess we're considered a mega ministry. Because you can't have more than 10 people, and we're at maximum, amen? So y'all come, welcome to the mega ministries of the Burns Memorial Church of God in Christ. We're sorry that we had to reject people at the door, but we're at the church parsonage, and we are having church, amen. And I want everybody to turn to Psalms 46. This is a very unique time in church history and in world history, and you know, it's a lot going on in the land. It's a lot of stuff with the coronavirus, you know, 19. You know, it's you know, people are, you know, fearing. You know, there's a lot of uncertainty all over the land. And you have a lot of fear. Just heard about somebody jumping out of a window in Manhattan and killing themselves because of the isolation that they were feeling because of, you know, the lockdown. And, you know, all over the land, people are, you know, destroyed. But we know that God is in control. We know that God is up to something. You know, anytime the devil gets to messing and bring and infirmities and pestilence and sickness and all kind of stuff and earthquakes and fires and tornadoes, we know that God is up to something. But we, with our finite minds, trying to understand the infinite mind of our Savior, you know, we're not going to understand, not at this side of the spectrum. But, you know, how many know when we get on the other side, you know, we're going to know it. We'll be known just as we are known. Amen. But we have to take the mind of Christ in this season. So I want to go to one of my favorite Psalms, Psalms 46. You know, the book of Psalms was written as, you know, songs. You know, David wrote some and different other people. Their chief musician wrote this one. You know, the sons of Korah wrote Psalms 46. You know, he had various people that God would inspire to write in those days. And so the book of Psalms is a collection of songs. Amen. And Psalms 46, we're going to really deal with that because I believe it's very, you know, what do you see? It's an on-time scripture for the time that we're living in. So we're going to break it down verse by verse because it's really not a long song. So it says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. You see that word refuge there? That word refuge is, you know, is what the musician is saying. He's saying that God is our shelter. He's our covering. Refuge is the place that literally you run to when there's calamity. A place that you consider safe. A place that, you know, is like a fortress. Refuge is a fortress. So what the musician is saying, he's saying that, you know, with all this stuff going on, God is my fortress. He's where I run. And, you know, I feel sorry because you got people going around talking about they're atheists and they're this and they're that and they don't believe in God. And with all this going on, it's like, man, if I don't know how you could even go day by day without not having God, you know, to run to. Because me, I'm a grown man and a lot of people consider me somebody who's courageous and bold and I wish I was like you, but they don't know. I'm just a scared little baby. Every little thing scares me. Every breath I take, I'm like, oh, Lord, something in the air. Somebody sneezes, I'm ready to run. right now with this coronavirus, you know? You touch me. Elbow that. You know, I'm a scared baby because I realized something. You cannot protect yourself in this world. I remember being an officer carrying a gun, and I remember having my gun, and some fellas rolled up on me, but their guns were already drawn. And what can I do? You know, I remember a time me and my brother got out the car, and we left somebody in the car, and we got out the car to go to one of those bodegas that's open late at night, and I left my gun in the car with the person in the car. And I'm out there, and these guys came up, and you could tell it was about the robbers. I looked at my brother looked at me because he thought I had my gun on me. Like, hey, bro. And I looked at him like, we got. And all I could do was say, Lord, please help me. Because that person in the car started to panic. They sure enough didn't come out with no gun. All right? But I remember the look that those guys gave us when they walked up on us. And then all of a sudden, they kind of ran away. You know? And the person in the car said, who's those guys that helped you? Who helped you? And I was like, there was nobody else out there but me and my brother. God had sent some angels to back the enemy up. Even though I had a gun, and that gun couldn't protect me. Do you see? We can't protect ourselves in this world. Unless we have something greater than ourselves, we're flesh and blood. We're finite. At the snap of a dime, our life could be snuffed out. But the musician, he must have had some experience with God. You understand? They must have been through some stuff and God came through. You know, and just like them, I can say that, you know, God did. I couldn't have done it. He's my strength. He's my refuge. He's the rock that I run to. He's my shielding when the enemy is shooting those fiery darts at me. He says, he's my refuge and my strength. But then it says, a very present help in trouble. That situation at that bodega outside, that was present trouble. It came upon me in the present. I couldn't, you know, it wasn't planned or anything. They couldn't have planned it because who knew what I was going to pull up to go to the store at that moment? You know, but God knew. See, God can see afar off. He can see behind, he can see at the sides, he can go into your past, he can go into your future, all right, because he's not confined by time. God is omnipotent, he's omniscient, meaning he's all-knowing, omnipotent, all-powerful. So God can be everywhere at the same time. So he's a present help. You know, and as a child of God, I can call on him in the present, in the moment. You know, there's some things that you cannot plan. But see, if you know that God is with you, if you believe that God is with you, you can call on him. Amen? Old folks used to say, call on him in the morning, call on him in the afternoon, and call on him in the evening. Amen? Second verse. The psalmist says, therefore, will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. Now, I want you to see that. First thing the psalmist is saying, don't fear. Now, you know when they say don't fear, that connotates that we're going to have the inclination to fear. See, God understands that, you know, our flesh is going to feel fear. But how many know that wherever fear is, there's faith lurking to counter that. But wherever faith is, there's fear lurking to counter that. So then, if God is saying, don't fear, that means that we have the ability to not fear. But how do we not fear? We have to shift our focus. See, if you keep focusing on this coronavirus, you keep focusing on, oh, is she sick, he's sick, am I going to catch it? Oh, it's running rampant through the land. Fear is just going to grip you. But if you focus on how big your God is, how great your God is, how powerful your God is, then fear has to back up, sit down, because faith jumps up. And faith is the most powerful force in the universe. How many know that? The greatest force on this earth is faith. And God said, I have not given you the spirit of fear, but of a sound mind. He says, I've dealt to every man a measure of faith. In other words, God created this world by faith. He stepped in and said, let there be, believing that it will be. And it was. He didn't come in with no doubt, because he knew, let there be and it's got to be. And we got to step up with that same faith. We got to say, no plague's going to enter my dwelling place. Enemy not coming in here. As for me and my house, we serve the Lord. The blood is coming over my doorpost. I'm encamped about with angels. See, I've lived over a half a century now. All right? And I've seen many troubles come on this land. I've seen diseases run through. All right? Since the 1900s, we've had smallpox. We've had all kinds of things. Wiped out a lot of people. But one thing I have not seen the enemy overtake me yet. David said, I was young and now I'm old. And I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. I have not seen God let me down.